This is my week 8 final project for this course. This project has two parts. The first component is the written component. The second component is this part, the video. And we were to research a different culture, country, or region of the world and research their communication style, whether it be their nonverbal communication, or their workplace communication, or the school place. And I wasn't really sure what country to search. I didn't really have any ideas. So I was talking to one of my friends about this project, and I was telling her, I don't know what country I should choose. And she said South America. So I wrote my project on South America. So I researched their communication styles, and I found that there is a misunderstanding of communication. So by this, I mean that here in the States, I think it's pretty typical. Someone asks for something and they're going to throw it at you. That sounds bad. Don't throw anything at anybody. You toss it. We gently toss it, like a pen or a water bottle or something. We toss it to them, so we save ourselves a few steps and we keep going about our work and we don't have to get up out of our chairs. And in Latin America, that is considered impolite and rude to toss something to somebody. The proper way is to get up, walk over, and hand it to them very politely and gently and not toss it to them or throw anything at them. So that was interesting. I never really thought of it like that as being impolite, but I guess if you use the word throw, I won't want anything thrown at me either. But toss, if you just gently toss something, then yeah, I can see that. People toss things quite a bit, I think. And then a big part of my project was the nonverbal communication. I think I've said this before. I am a communications minor, so this is not my first communications course. And in every textbook, the authors have had a whole chapter dedicated to nonverbal communication. So that just is reinforcing how important nonverbal communication is. And it's not always cut and dry. So our nonverbal communication here is completely different from, say, South America, because that's the country I chose. So an example of this is hand gestures. It's like when I talk, I've been moving my hands a lot. You probably can't see it, but I do. I talk with my hands, and I don't know why I do that, but I do. There's the one hand gesture for like, come here. And when I do come here, I do this. Just like, come here, I need to talk to you, or something like that. And the come here hand gesture is described as your hand, palm up, and the index finger extending in and out 3 or 4 times. I don't know, I just do this. I just do this for come here. And the come here hand gesture is different in Latin America. In Latin America, if you do this to somebody, that is soliciting a person into thinking you want to start a romantic relationship with them. So that is good information to know. So if you ever travel to South America, don't go doing this to somebody because they'll think, oh, they want to start up a relationship. No, that's not true. And their come here is distinguished by extending your hand palm down and move all 4 fingers in and out together 3 or 4 times. I don't know if I'm interpreting that right either. And then I also talked about the high context and the low context. And South America is considered a high context culture. And that was back in chapter 6. So that was a while ago. But high context cultures just means that there is a lot of reliance on how something is said rather than what is said, and they are accurately aware of nonverbal cues. So it's not just hearing the words, but it's also hearing what they don't say. So that's another nonverbal cue, being able to interpret what somebody is saying, or I guess lack of not saying. And so I searched that for my project, the nonverbal cues. And that's what I found for my research in communications and culture in South.